हेलो वेलकम अगेन, वी आर सॉल्विंग सम कन्वेंशनल क्वेश्चंस ऑफ पावर प्लांट। टॉपिक इज सीन साइकिल। क्वेश्चन नंबर 51 फ्रॉम इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट मेन 2015। इन ए BWR टाइप न्यूक्लियर रिएक्टर द हीट ऑफ न्यूक्लियर फिजन इज ट्रांसफर्ड टू वाटर। इन ए रिएक्टर वाटर कम्स आउट ऑफ द रिएक्टर एज सैचुरेटेड वेपर एट 72 bar। द स्टीम फ्लोज थ्रू द टर्बाइन एंड एग्जॉस्ट एट 0.08 bar टू ए कंडेंसर। द वाटर लीव द कंडेंसर एट 0.08 bar एंड 40 degrees सेल्सियस। एच इज इक्वल टू 176.5 किलोग्राम पर किलोग्राम। एंड द लिक्विड वाटर इज अगेन पम्प्ड थ्रू ए पम्प टू न्यूक्लियर रिएक्टर। आइसोट्रॉपिक एफिशिएंसी ऑफ द टर्बाइन इज 70%। द प्लांट हैज ए कैपेसिटी ऑफ 750 MW। कैलकुलेट मास फ्लो रेट ऑफ स्टीम सर्कुलेटेड एंड रेट ऑफ हीट जनरेशन। प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ स्टीम एट 0.08 bar HFG, SF एंड SFG आर गिवन एंड एट 72 bar HG एंड HG आर गिवन। सो दिस इज योर स्टीम साइकिल। सो दिस इज आइसेंट्रोपिक प्रोसेस इन टर्बाइन, आइडियल प्रोसेस इन टर्बाइन एंड दिस इज एक्टिव प्रोसेस इन टर्बाइन, दैट इज 1-2 bar। This is condenser, this is pump, this is reactor. And this pressure is 72 bar and at 1, the steam is dry and saturated. So at 72 bar, HG will be here or H1 will be here 2770.9 kg per kilogram. And entropy is 5.8019 from the given property. Okay. So, now entropy at 0.2 and entropy at 0.1 is same because this is isentropic process. So S1 is 5.18019 and S2 is summation of entropy at 0.3 and plus summation plus this entropy, that is during phase change. So that is for here for dynamic exchange H2. So it will be X2 into 7.6370 and these two things we have obtained from the given data. So at 0.08 bar SF is 0.5926 and SFG is 7.67670. So from this we can find out X2 and then again using the enthalpy, that is HF and HFG, we can find out the enthalpy at 0.2. Okay, so that is 1813 kilojoule per kilogram. And isentropic efficiency of turbine is given as you know that it is H1 minus H2 divided by H1 minus H2. So H1 minus H2 is ideal, that is isentropic, and H1 minus H2 is actual. So that is given as 0.7. So H1 is 2770.9 and H2 is 1813. So we can find out H1 minus H2 as well as H2 because you know H1. So H2 comes as 2100 kilojoule per kilogram and H1 minus H2 comes as 670.53 kilojoule per kilogram. And H3 is 30.3, which is saturated with liquid, that is 173.9 kilojoule per kilogram. And assuming that neglecting the pump work, H3 will be equal to H4. So air pump work is very small, so we can neglect it. So it will be 173.9 kilojoule per kilogram. And total turbine power is given as 750 megawatt or 750 into 10 power 6. So for them is the mass of steam flowing, and turbine power is given by m into change in specific enthalpy, actual specific enthalpy, that is H1 minus H2 into m will be equal to 750 into 10 power 6. So from this we can find out m. So m comes out as 1118 kilogram per second, and rate of heat generation is m H1 minus H4 because steam is generated from 4 to 1. So m is the mass of the steam and H1 minus H4 is change in specific enthalpy. And putting the value of, because we know H1, we know H4, and we know mass, so we can find out this rate of regeneration, that is 2903.54 megawatt. dividing it by 1000 to convert kilowatt into megawatt.